Hey guys, welcome back to Blood Will Tell. Thank you so much for tuning in today. Really appreciate having you. So we're gonna head over to this eastern room. We're gonna investigate that door that I decided not to go in yesterday because we were running out of time, right here on top of this box. Now we're just gonna hit circle and open it up like so. Okay, you know, first time I played this, I wasn't sure if you could actually get in there because, you know, it's at a higher level. I actually have to replay this. I played for about 15 minutes and then the video just inexplicably died. It's very unfortunate. So yeah, this isn't going to be blind starting off. I do apologize. We need consumable items because this boss that we're about to fight is a huge asshole. Let's just put it that way. So we tried to go through that door. All these fiends spawn in the room. What we're going to do is actually, well, since you came down to my level, I want to do is critical flash you while you're all alone so I can start building up items. Yeah, like so. It's such a good way to earn items, viewers. 28 seems to be my limit right about now. As you can see, we got some mortar shells, a wealth of medicine. Damn. Alrighty. Definitely take that. Definitely get hit by, I don't know what that was. Was that the dog? I don't think the golems have ranged attacks, do they? Well, they may. And we're gonna head up here, get this doggy all alone, hello puppy, and fucking stab him repeatedly. I am the Michael Vick of the Asians. Here we go. Michael Vick didn't stab any dogs. What are you talking about? Okay, so 10 shells. What are we gonna do with these? I'd like to take one of these guys down with one of these delicious shells, like so. Massive damage. God damn, that feels good. And then what we're going to do is take down this last guy. Oh, Rolling Fiend. Yeah, you need to get the hell out of here, don't you, buddy? There you go. And stab this guy. Whoop, damn it. Totally botched that. Yeah, definitely botched that. Okay, let's try that again. And it's really unfortunate. When I played this last, I definitely didn't do that. But I got this fucking incredible sword from getting 28 hits on one of these rock dudes. It was the Lux Sword +3. It did massive damage. It gave a huge luck boost. And yeah, I'm not going to get that lucky again because it's not going to drop. So if you ever want a really good sword drop, you should consider farming those guys because it was fucking cool. And it was also like a really long sword and it glowed purple. I seriously was like immediately in love with it and I'm sad that we're not going to have it anymore. But the fucking video died in the middle of a cutscene and we are not missing cutscenes. If it was gameplay, I would consider trying to do some editing, but it was one of the more important cutscenes in the entire game, so yeah, we're not missing that. Let's go ahead and head through the door here. Oh, shit! Almost totally forgot about that. I did the exact same thing last time. Flamethrowers. Yeah, you definitely want to just jump over these. You don't need to really time it out. You can just double jump, no problem. And if you look ahead, you can see a tiny pixelated man there off in the distance. Who is it, viewers? Who do you think it is? Let's just jump on over. And get ready.
This time, I will not fail.
Why are you determined to kill me?
So that I may live.
What's that got to do with me? I don't know what you're talking about, but I must defeat you to get back my body parts.
Your body parts? What are you talking about?
Savurota, I hope you don't expect me to go easy on you.
Of course!
And here we go, we have our final showdown with Eyebrows Snake Eyes Sabrota. Man, it's gonna be harrowing, seriously. This guy does not fuck around. I went into this really cocky and immediately paid for it. I actually managed to beat him without losing a life. But it was so goddamn harrowing and stressful. He has a wealth of new attacks, he's incredibly agile, and just strong as all get out, honestly. You really don't ever get just an amazing opportunity to attack him. Like, that actually wasn't pretty bad. That's one of the better spirit attacks I've ever got off. Going toe with him, he will always have the upper hand. You can't stun him with your attacks, but he can definitely fuck your world up with his. So just be very careful. Just try and whittle him down. This fight, at least from what I saw, isn't about just doing massive quantities of damage at a time. It's about just whittling his fucking monkey ass down. I hate this guy so much. He's so goddamn fast. You can't really get any critical hits off on him at all. It's still a really good opportunity to attack him while he does his sword flash, similar to when you fought him earlier. But even then, it's a lot different than it was before. We've already done a whole bar of damage, which is actually really amazing. So we're just going to be very careful. All of his attacks, again, very fast, and a lot of them have huge range, as you saw with his little aerial ability where he shot the projectile down. He also shoots out flaming rings and shit like that. Oh, he's just so terrible. Maybe a sword of fire, something like that, I'm not entirely sure. Would probably be a lot better, honestly. Ah, fuck. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to actually back off for a moment. We've lost a decent amount of health. And spam bullets. Ah, shit. Get out of there. Spam bullets to build up our spear gauge to our next attack level, as it is right now. And get it off. Again, just trying to whittle them down as much as possible. I mainly use the bullets to just build up spirit. It does minor damage, but it's really nothing to shake a stick at, honestly. There we go. Building it up ever so slightly. And when he's dashing at you like that, it's actually really it behooves you to try and hit him with mortar shells. I know it's super risky, but if you hit him with two, you can actually stun him and knock him onto the ground. Am I back to one-handed? Yeah, I am. Alright, one-handed. Yeah, he's running at me slow. I'm totally aiming the wrong fucking direction, so it really didn't matter, but that's the perfect opportunity to do that. So let's just back the hell off, and maybe get a couple off. Yep, point blank, one, two. It did not stun him, okay? But actually, that's totally fine, because we did massive damage. Let's try it again. Are you running? What are you doing, buddy? I'm not going to shoot this, because I know you're just going to fucking instant transmit towards me or some bullshit. One and two, he's on the ground. That went really well. And we can get a few hits in. It's really probably a better idea to just run and prepare your next attack, honestly. But what can you do? All right. And, oh, fuck. If I could have landed behind him, that would have been just perfect. Well, definitely don't want to go aerial to aerial with him. You really don't want to go at all with him in any way. You don't want to go toe to toe. You don't want to be up in the air with him. You just want to be a cheap Dickens in this fight. Like right here, you can get him stun locked. He'll just keep trying to counterattack, and he can't hit you. And when you're doing that, again, not much damage, but your spirit gauge is slowly increasing. Come on, Hiyaki. Oh, that was perfect. One, two, three. This is basically what I did to kill him last time. I used all of my goddamn shells, just being a cheap prick. Looks like we're going to come out a little bit ahead with two mortar shells, because I don't actually plan on using any more. We should have enough left in the tank to take him down. Good job, Hiyaki.
I did it. I defeated the man created by the fiends. If what I heard at the temple is true, then I will regain all my body parts.
Hiyakimaru, before I die, tell me something. What did you mean by getting your body parts back?
Long ago, I heard a voice at a temple. It said my quest would end if I defeated the man created from my body parts.
You got it all wrong. The fiends didn't use your body parts to make me. I'm nothing but a puppet, created only to destroy you.
What?
Tough luck. The fiends told me that they would give me a heart if I defeated you.
You don't have a heart?
No. It was to make sure I couldn't leave the lands they controlled. If I had a heart, I could have lived free.
Saburota.
That kid traveling with you. Dororo, was it? That's the one you're looking for. They created Dororo with your body parts.
What?
I speak the truth. I'm surprised you never realized it. Why else do you think you could communicate telepathically? Just kill Dororo, and I'm sure you'll get back all the body parts you want.
I'll get my body back if I kill Dororo? I can't. I just can't. I can't kill Dororo. I don't care how long it takes. I'll kill all the fiends myself!
Damn. Did any of you see that coming? I know I didn't the first time I played. Good God, that's a lot to take in. Here we are, back in the gameplay. I'm not ready to play, man. I'm still soaking all that bullshit in. Jesus. Wait, There's a room over here to the east. Oh, that's where I came from, obviously. Actually, no, it isn't. The fuck is that? It doesn't want me to go over there yet. Yeah, and it's kind of blocked off, isn't it? Maybe. No, we can totally jump in here. But yeah, it's... Well done, Hiaki. Well done. But yeah, it's pretty fucked up, isn't it? We could end all of this if we just kill our companion that we've had with us literally the entire game. Oh, this is where I came from. So what was up north? Well, I apologize, viewers. Let's go ahead and just do this proper. For some reason, I remember, like, a long-ass bridge. Whatever. We're just gonna head on. I'm too confused with this shit. I'm all flustered. I'm emotional. I don't give a fuck about anything right now. We're definitely not killing Dororo. No. No. So we're gonna head on. We're gonna take down each fiend individually, just rip their fucking bodies apart, and get our bodies back. That's how that shit's gonna go down. Now, oh, what's in here? I should say that the video actually ended during that cutscene, so this is blind again.
Dororo, you're safe.
You too.
Where's Tohomaru?
He's helping the others escape. He said he'll meet up with us later.
All right, let's go.
Okay.
Now, if I remember correctly, she has a ton of items that I need to collect off her. Well, actually, just mainly medicine, right? So let's go ahead and grab that and see what the hell's going on. Yeah, 39. Damn. Ah, still not enough, though, eh? Yeah, we're only at 57. Shit. Man, I really gotta do some grinding. Okay, so let's not go in there. Oh, definitely gotta save. That fight was fucking terrible. I should probably go, like, get some new swords. After I beat this chapter, before we do the last one, I have a lot of grinding to do. I need to get my lives up. I need to probably get some new swords. Level up my own swords. We'll see how it goes. We'll see if I can even beat this one before I even talk. Alright, what? Oh no, fiends have spawned. Oh, who didn't see that coming? Okay, well that's fun. Come here, buddy. These are actually really straightforward. Yeah, straightforward fiends. So I can just essentially mash the square button and take them all down. I should actually... Well, I'd like to get a few of them alone to do some grinding, but honestly, that's just not gonna happen. These guys love to stick together. Damn! I am smoking them, though. Alrighty, and off you go. We have like one super strong one left over there. So I'll see if I can't kill him in a... Oh shit, Dororo, kill that other one, quick. Alright, let's kill this guy. And then we'll take this other one down all flashy pants like. Off you go. See if I can't get up to... How about up above 28, you think I can? I know I could. If I... Oh no, I totally hit triangle, that's bullshit. I know I could if I wasn't recording. God damn. God damn. Okay. Whoa. Hello there. There's a door. What? What is happening? Okay, it was like smushing me into the ground. I want to jump on you. Let me jump on you. Oh shit, I can. Okay, let's go up here. Is it? Oh, I don't need to do a fancy maneuver. I can just jump on that tiny little platform. Hey. A little bit of health. Why not? I'm really nervous about proceeding without any sort of projectiles. Like, honestly. But, fuck me, right? Who am I to prepare? We're just gonna wing this shit. Speaking of wings, annoying ass birds. So this one actually takes me to a proper location. I notice there's another little alcove here on the far end, so before I go in there, let's investigate what the hell is going on in this general direction. Hey, invincibility. That's totally fucking useless, isn't it? Dororo, can you, like, carry this for me? And store it? Or, when you pick it up, do you just use it? I'm not entirely sure how this works with Dororo. Honestly, she can't even get the fuck up here, so... Fuck me, right? Alright, there you go. Nope. Use. Yeah, easy. No. Dororo. There you go. No. I could watch this shit all day. You can do it! One more chance. Oh, you blew it. Well, what if I, like, do my little summon here? There you go. Now, grab this shit. Yeah, she doesn't pick it up at all. Fuck. Okay, well, it's fine. Total waste of time. Everyone's goddamn time. But that's okay. Oh, what's going on up here? Wait, is this where it wants me to go? All the way around? We missed that giant square room. Alright, well then, let's head back that way. Lost and confused. The plasticallan story. Seriously. If there's any better way to describe me, let me know. I don't think there really is. Bullshit luck. Plasticallan in a nutshell. I don't know. Up into the middle area we go. Yeah, what is this giant open-ass room? Is there another fiend?
A demon aura.
Eh? A fiend. Man, I'm not prepared for this guy at all, so let's do it. Oh, this is one of the optional fiends, eh? Fair enough. Okay, it's this guy. Another ogre? No, it's not an ogre. What is that? Fuck. I know we fought one of these before, and I can't think of what their name is at all. Well, it's definitely not Blood Gore that was in my head, but what can you do? Alright, Al Gore, let's just spirit attack you, like, right off the bat. Again, so we can just constantly build up our spirit attack as we fight. What does he do? Oh no, he shoots out fucking nasty evil tornadoes, a giant plasma ball. Alright, all of his attacks relatively slow. He does have a great range with that spear, and I just happen to notice that that tornado's still trying to get me, so we do need to be... Whoa, surprised that didn't hit me. Need to be a little bit careful, but I know his critical hit spot is right in his fucking ugly dome. Considering I just fought goddamn Eyebrows McGee and he was hard as hell, this is just a walk in the fucking park. I gotta say, why is this, like, fighting people my size, why is it so much fucking harder? I don't know. Alrighty, but he's already down to one health bar. This is gonna be a great way to end the video, basically, is what I'm trying to say. Oh my god, can I... Oh, I shouldn't say it, but I'm gonna say it anyway. Can we get a flawless victory, viewers? Can I jinx myself as I always do? I think I can. Whew, still didn't take damage, though. That tornado, although intimidating, not as intimidating as three tornadoes, but even then, not that fucking scary. They're really... You cocktease. I hate you so much. I was like 2 hits away from the flawless, and I botched it. Well, you blew it, Alan. You blew it, Alan. You blew it. So what else are we gonna get today? Well, actually, we haven't got anything. I forgot. We didn't get shit from Eyebrows, so that sucks. Oh, yes, of course. It's that other organ that I totally know how to pronounce, and by organ, I mean chakra. Cool. I'm so glad we got that. Finally, I've been waiting desperately for that. Oh, I can breathe a sigh of relief. Alrighty, so back into the game we go. And we're just going to continue, I guess, walking around the side of the castle. Now that I've already got this guy, probably just speed it. Like, I don't really want to farm for items at all. I'm just gonna run, get to the next save point, if and I can. Alright, get these rolling guys out of here. These ballista are actually pretty impressive, I gotta say. It's great design. This fucking castle, though, horrifying, right? Can you imagine trying to siege this castle? It would just be miserable. What am I doing? Like, can someone tell me what I'm doing, please? Where am I going? I don't fucking know at all. Can I cut this down for, like, items? No, can't cut this one down. If I go this way, isn't this just the way that I came? Where am I? Yeah, it is. Why did I go that way? I guess there were bullets on the platform, but there's really nothing else. Bullets are definitely welcome at this juncture, let's just be completely honest. Yeah, I'm just gonna try and go as fast as possible. There's a fiend. He's guarding some more bullets. 50. Yes, excellent. Gonna need those. Now, will this middle one lead me to another area? No. It leads me to 2 pissed off skeletons. They went ahead and just taught me a lesson and knocked my ass down. I'm gonna heed that lesson and just move the hell on. Whoa. Watch those guys. Back up to full. How much further am I going to have to run around this side here, honestly? I feel like I'm playing Wind Waker or something. There's actually a dead end here. Wow, with thwomps shooting fireballs. It's not a dead end. Sweet. At least I... Oh, wow. Damn good shot. I gotta say, not even mad about that. So it's a good thing I kind of experimented with that corner before that had the bullets on it, because I knew to look for one here. Alrighty. I'm so full of shit. So we're on the last stretch of land. Let's go ahead and look for a way out of here. When I go up into this room, I should see it. Alright, the middle. We want to go to the middle. Recovered all of my spirit. We've gotten a decent amount of projectiles back. It's not ideal, but we're doing alright. I still really wish I had another one up. Jesus Christ. So let's quickly investigate in here and grab a sword. Yeah, that's what I want. Give me a sword. Oh, it's full health. Damn it. I don't need that shit at all. I needed it a little bit. Here we go. I'm gonna head into the middle and maybe... Honestly, I don't know what to expect. I don't think... Wow, it's a lot of Tengu there. I don't expect that we're gonna have a really big boss fight. But I guess we are. It's gonna be a long-ass video, man. What's going on in here? Oh, I fought one of you before. in the, which one was it? Was it chapter one? I think it was one. It was an optional fiend. Maybe it was two, but I want to say one. Anyways, we're fighting the nutsack demon, Carrion Feeder. Okay. What is he going to do? Green. Jesus, that's bright. Okay. Doro, just keep throwing rocks, lady. You got this. I have the tiger and all that good shit. So, that attack is pretty damn scary. I can kind of grind into him to dodge it, but not really. How is our damage looking? He seems to have a decent amount of endurance. Although, considering we've only had like two rounds of attacks, we're actually doing alright. And his overall attack power? Not so bad. I need to figure out where his critical hit spot is, though, because occasionally I seem to be hitting it. But then, for the most part, I'm like, not. I'm very confused as to what it is. It's not the tip of his dick, it's not like him and his eye. Maybe it's just attacking from behind? Not sure. Let's go ahead, spirit attack it up. Oh yeah, I knew he was going to teleport away, but it at least caused me to dodge the bullshit that he was casting. This guy seems exactly like the one that we fought before. Shooting out the projectiles, yeah, the AoE attack. I don't remember the stun, but still, this isn't too bad. Oh my god, that was weird. Let's see if I can't get my... I want to get my square combo off that one, because it actually does a fuck ton of damage if I can actually get it. You saw me do it against Eyebrows. It's pretty damn nice, that one there. Alrighty. Just getting close. Keep chucking your rocks at him. You'll get him. If I could just, like, charge it up before I got near him, it'd actually work really well. So what we'll do, we'll dodge this bullshit. That's really scary. Wind it up, and the pitch. It's a miss. What's he gonna do here? Miniature balls? I actually really like the miniature ball attack. That one's even easier to dodge. Look at this guy. This is just pathetic. You're like one of the endgamey fiends, man. You gotta show us a little bit more pizzazz, right? I'm just rinsing repeating here. You only have two main attacks, it seems. Yeah, not too impressed. Alright, well, whatever. Come here, buddy. Do a little bit more. Probably two more teleports from him, and then we will be done with this nonsense. However, this is an optional fiend. I must have missed a pathway somewhere. Because I don't see a way out of here, honestly. Do you? I don't think there is. Anyways, let's grab this next body part. What the hell is this gonna be? Can I pronounce this one? Sincerely hope so. Not even gonna try! Alright, we got another chakra. This one. Ah, we need all the other ones, and when we have all the other chakras, we will get a massive luck boost, apparently. God damn, I miss you, Luck Sword plus 3. I want to go back in time. Okay. Where the fuck do I need to go? This is a dead end. You know, actually, I'm thinking. I made a note of something. I didn't actually comment on it. But when I was running around outside, at one part, what fucking part was it? I noticed something that was actually, like, underneath me. Maybe it wants me to go there. Alright, check this out. I'll show you what I'm talking about. It's a little bit hard to describe. We're gonna need to go back to this area. Wow. That thwomp, man. I'm telling you. GG thwomp. Ooh, that was ballista, though. They even attack like the thwomps. Like, what the fuck were they thinking? Okay, let's see if I can't just make a simple as fuck jump, shall we? Yeah, check this out. It's on this platform here. Towards the middle. I can't get a camera angle. Like, what? There's something down there. Yeah, see? Is this actually where it wants me to go? It appears to be. What do we got down here? We got just more of these guys and, like, a hidden passageway. This way has a lot of fiends. This way has the proper way to go. I don't have much time. Can I just take a quick glance as to what's in here? Looks like a place that... Ow, 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 ow. Looks like a place I can kind of restore my stuffs. What the fuck are these? They're super easy. Ugh, they're creepy as shit too. Okay, I got a level up off of them, so I'm not about to argue. And 24, I'm just not gonna risk it, biscuit. Eh? Did he just not drop anything at all for all of that? I have never seen that before, holy shit. And what's your deal? Like, seriously, what the fuck is this? Well, at least I know, or rather, I'm thinking that I had to come in here. Because there appears to be a giant switch. No! Ah, botched it. Alright, that's fine. What did that switch do? It must have opened up a way. Eh? Why are there red dots over here? Oh, there's a second like a second story. How do I get up there? Doro, use a throwing knife. I want to climb. So I guess there are enemies up above, but I... What? Now something else moved. Oh, hey. I somehow moved this door around. I don't know why I'm determined to, like, critical hit these guys. That first one, it just mystified me that it didn't drop anything, so I want to see if I can get lucky. And maybe they'll... Totally fucking pointless. Yeah, what a waste of time. Okay, well, won't be doing that again. But we're gonna follow these red dots on the map. Two more, or rather just one more, dude. Come here, duder. Oh, I want to critical hit him again. Alright, one more, come on. Get the fuck out of here. I don't understand these enemies at all. Let's go above 28. We're not gonna do it at this pace. No, 28 it is. Alright. And we get... Ooh! What? A sword. What is this? What is it? What kind of sword did we get? The Murm... What? Are you shitting me? That thing is badass. 46? Holy fuck. Damn. Dude, I don't want to use my regular sword anymore. Holy shit. Also, I hit a switch over here, and I have no fucking clue what it did, but holy shit, look at this sword, man. Wow, okay, let's go ahead and get the hell out of this room. I am so happy. So apparently if you see those little midget demons that don't really do dick, that was a mistake. That was a poorly thought out decision. Fucking just keep critical hitting them until you get this sword. Because look at this thing. Holy shit. Alright, I'm going to assume that hitting that switch allowed me to like progress further in this area. Just for my own sanity's sake. But even if it didn't, I'm still very happy with what went down in that room. I'm like shaking up. I'm stuttering. Okay. So we're going to go up here real quick. I need to not spend too much time because this video is getting a little long. I do apologize, but I do want to collect as many of these shells as possible. I do want to ignore as many of these enemies as possible. One of them, several of them definitely just died inexplicably. I'm not sure what the fuck happened. I'm not about to argue with it. Let's try out this new sword. See how much damage it does. One hand. Yeah, it's pretty cool looking. Probably not the best chance to, or best place to try it out. This is in fact a kill room, so... We're just going to speed things up here. Actually, maybe I'll spirit attack them both. Try and save a shell. Spirit attack regenerates very quickly. So I'm going to need you two to just group up for me real quick, please. Form a single file line. There we go. And Asa Lasagna. Don't get any rocks on you. Because they are nasty business. Damn! That one got me good. Alright. Well then. You know what that means? Now that you're alone... I'm like trying to make up for all of the times I didn't use this move during the LP. And just spamming the fuck out of it this video. Yes! Nice! Nice! And nice. I could really use a save point game, though. I'm not about to lie about it. Grab that. Get the fuck over here. It looks really... Yeah, this is looking really, really endgamey now. So, I guarantee you there's going to be a save point right about now. The Funk Soul Brother. Check it out now. A cutscene. Brother. Just kidding. It's a final battle. The final battle with Daigo's soldiers. Is this a non-lethal? Yeah, it is non-lethal. Okay. I couldn't tell exactly because I thought I saw blood. But, it's my blood. Nobody makes me bleed my own blood. But I looked up and I noticed that I couldn't like switch over to mortars or anything. That's a pretty easy way to tell, honestly. This is the final battle. I did see a save point in this room, so after we complete this, no need to worry, viewers. You can finally relax. Actually, you can't really relax because we're probably going to have the last big fight of this chapter here tomorrow. And it's going to be goddamn hard if Snake Eyes was any indication of that. Snake! Snake! Get out of here, man. Seriously. These guys are just being wrecked by this fucking amazing sword that I found. God damn, look at it, man! I'm just so enamored by this. This fucking guy is ruining my invincibility. I'm not too happy about him at all. He's just an archer, okay. Well then, I can't blame him for trying to back away. Now, one more. He's way the dick over here. Hey, buddy, how's it going? One fell swoop. Damn.
Above here? Daigo. I'm coming for you.
That was incredibly dramatic. You gotta say, I approve of that. Alrighty, well, that about does it for today. Sorry about the video length. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. Seriously, join me tomorrow, and we will see if we can't wrap up this chapter. Have a great night, guys.